So, hello, welcome back to my channel. This time with another interesting info video for you guys. I am not sure, this is an unlisted video, but everybody can see it from Wargaming. And it's about some very unique new kind of test bombers, I would say. As you can see, I will play the video in a second. It's only 17 seconds long, but you will see, it's very unique. We see a new carrier here. This is the Werner Voss, I guess. The W is Werner. It's new, but from the small picture here, it looks like just the normal tier 10 German carrier. But of course, when Wargaming is testing such new mechanics or stuff, they implement it with a completely new ship. So they rename the ship, there's no problem, I guess. And what are these bombers doing? I will show you. And after that, I will show you the carrier in-game. And we will talk about this. And I am very... yeah, let me know in the comments what you think about these new mechanics. I'm not the biggest carrier guy, as you know, some of you. Yeah, and I want your opinion on this one. And I will just play the tape so you can see what happens. They go down like torpedo planes, I would say. But then they drop what looks like AP bombs and they skip about the water. In German we say flitschen. Or hüpfen. We can replay this. It's only this clip. But it's very interesting. We can see here that there's actually the torpedo thingy shown here. Maybe it's very early and it's work in progress, of course. Like you can see, I have this overlay. And again, and we will stop it to talk about this real quick. So here you can see they hit the water and then they make a really big jump. I am not sure what this is for, if you can try to hit several targets maybe, but does this make sense? I don't know. Let me know. I know this this kind of things as this dam busters. I know the British used them in World War II to attack the German dams in the Ruhrgebiet. They used this kind of bombs to get over some protection. There were some nets or something. Maybe they even used it to hit something like the Tirpitz in the fjords, to jump over the protection nets and hit the targets. I am not sure. But I think it's very interesting. It will be kind of hard to use, I guess. And one last time, and then we go into the game and talk some more. Maybe I heard some rumors it's for the new it isn't even for the Germans. Maybe it's for the new Soviet carriers. I don't know. Let me know what you think, and let me quick go into the game with you. So there we are. Let me check. Yes, the recording is still there. There you can see it. It's in fact the Werner Voss Flugzeugträger Tier 10, but it's very much the normal Tier 10. It's very much the normal. You can see it's in German here, but there is... Oh, but it says bomber. Can be all kinds of bombers. Like I said, I think it's only to test this in-game. It's a very early test, but it is very interesting, I think. And it could be that they are planning on more tier 10 carriers. There is one other tier 10 carrier, which I'm going to show you in this video too. So we can cover this both in one. Again, don't be too hard on my English. I'm still learning and I'm getting used to it. I think in the next 100 videos or so. And let me know what I can improve. Maybe I can do some things better. But I pretty much want to go how you say it, one take, and don't have any real scripts or something, because I want to share my raw thoughts about the ships here. Nice, there was some background sounds. I don't know if you heard this. Yeah, that's the Werner Voss and that's the new bombers. I'm very excited about this one and we will see. And now I will show you, I hope the picture is right. Yes, but I think it is. We can reset this. And the work in progress is still there, so I can show you the other interesting carrier that I want to show you. What is, of course, the Franklin D. Roosevelt, which is a Midway class carrier of tier 10. And of course, we have the Midway as a normal tier 10. Here you can see it in all the glory, the names on premium ships. I often mentioned it in my streams that all the premium ships get their names on their asses and on the ship in general. And I hate it. I really hate it why they don't do this with the Bismarck or with some other great ships. Yamato. I don't know if Yamato had actually the name on it, but I think you know what I mean. And this is the Franklin D. Roosevelt. It's much more interesting, I think, because it's the second version we are testing right now. I am not allowed, or we are not allowed, to show you some gameplay of this one, but I can show you in port all there is to see. I won't stack a captain on this, so these are all stock parameters you see here, but they are very interesting nevertheless. So let's go over it real quick so you can see anything. And if there are any questions to the first ship or the new bombers or this one, you may use the comment section, or you may use my Discord server. All is linked below the video. So we have a nice armored deck with 87 millimeters. We have some good citadel protection here. So like the Midway, it's well protected against a long range sniping attempts or something, I would say. Interesting, this deck also protected here, this little area. This is this. Not that interesting. Hit points, a good amount. Torpedo protection, 25. We may compare it a bit to the Midway here. It's the same protections, 67. And we have 67. It's basically just a Midway, so to say. The difference comes with the different planes here. And I will hover this with my mouse so you can get all the information. I won't read you all the data. This is here. We have some rocket planes. Attacking size is 2 Flugzeuge planes per attack wing is 14. That's the trait of the Roosevelt. They are very big attack formations, you know. All Sky Pirates, by the way, all the same basic plane, which is very nice looking with this double prop. Torpedoes, 35 knots, 40 kilometer in range. I think you can get all the things, even if you use another language. Hey, stay here. And again, we have 2 attacking airplanes and 14 total per attack. And the last one is the bombers. What are HE? And again, 2 attacking and 14 in one attacking group. So you have a lot of attacks with one of these. The protection of the planes is actually pretty good, I think. Where do I see? Ah, there, at the top. I see it at the top. 3,200, 3,200. Here we have 3,690, and here we have 3,700. Compare to the Midway, real quick. Just to get an idea. Oh, wow. Wow, pretty good. And this is with a captain, and the Roosevelt is without a captain. So you see the hit points of the planes is insanely high on the Roosevelt. Okay. I am not allowed to share any experience I had with this plane, with this ship, which is very easy on at this point, because as you can see, I didn't play this version. I have to go for it, but it's much easier to do the review for you now, so I won't tell you anything I'm not allowed, you know what I mean. Anyways, it looks very nice. We will finish this one real quick. We have some secondaries, 14x1, and the midway has 18x1, bit more here. But the Roosevelt has these are the planes. The plane number is very, very high here with, so Flugabwehr, anti-air is midways 98 to Roosevelt's 95. Keep in mind, it's without any modules, without any captain. So it's pretty insane. We have this one, 33 knots, 1200. I will compare this. Midway is faster, but we have signals. We have a captain, should be this. And the concealment last. Again, this is stock. Yeah, this is stock, and I guess I have some camo on, you know, some better concealment here. So last one to finish this one, we will check the modules if I can do so. Yes, I can, but I guess they are pretty much the same as Midway. I will show you. Okay, damage con. Here you can choose the type. Yes, okay. That's pretty much normal tier 10, I would say. Yes, nevertheless. Very interesting. I don't have information, and I am not allowed, if I had it, what kind of resources this will be. Maybe it's out there, then I am sure somebody will tell us in the comments. Tier 10 premium carriers. I am not so sure about this one, but they will come. They will come, as we see with the Werner Voss and with the Roosevelt. So, looking forward. Let me know what you think in the comments. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like this kind of content too, because there is a lot of more to come in this form. So, let me know what you think. Hit the like button. If you don't have subscribed to the channel, maybe this is an argument for you to do so now. And anyways, have a great day and see you next time. Bye bye.